Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about a chromaticity and chromaticity diagram. So let's begin with the topic. In color television, chromaticity consists of an important part, as it is a combination of two important parameters that are related with the colors. Basically, chromaticity is nothing but the objective specification that defines quality of the light or quality of the color, irrespective of its luminance. Luminance is nothing but the amount of light intensity received by the human eye. In case of black and white color, the intensity, or we can say the luminance, of white parts is more as compared to dark part. That means the intensity of the dark color is less as compared to white color. Basically, chromaticity consists of two main parameters, and the parameters are nothing but hue and saturation. Hue is nothing but the predominant color of light received by the human eye from the spectra of light. In case of hue, if we are considering the example of the dark color, then in case of dark color, the hue having a larger value. Now moving to the second parameter, that is nothing but a saturation. It defines the purity of the light or purity of the color. When the color is pure, for example, if you are considering the example of vivid green color, then it has a larger amount of saturation. And as the color is get mixed with the white, the saturation value is get decreases. The light green color is obtained from vivid green color when white color is get added into it. Now, when we talk about hue, then the hue is basically used. It is also called as tint, and it is used to distinguish the color based on the wavelength of the color. For example, a leaf, or example, a green leaf having a green tint or green hue. Red tomatoes having red hue. So basically, hue is used for differentiating the color, and that differentiation is based on the wavelength of the color from spectra of light. Now in this topic, we are going to talk about a next step of the chromaticity, that is nothing but the chromaticity diagram. So let's start with it. So basically, the chromaticity diagram is convenient space coordinate representation of all spectral colors and their mixtures based on the trisimilars values of primary color contained by them. As we know, in case of color television, the color is obtained by additive or subtractive mixing. So basically, the chromaticity diagram provides a coordinates which related to the colors of the spectral of the light and their mixtures. That means it consists of three primary colors, that is RGB, along with their mixtures. Now the figure is that we are going to see consists of two-dimensional representation of hue and saturation in the XY plane. As the chromaticity, or we can say chroma, or we can say a brightness, is nothing but the combination of hue and saturation. So when we plot a chromaticity diagram, it basically consists of these two parameters, that is hue and saturation. Now when we consider the three-dimensional structure, then we require to consider z-axis, and z-axis represents brightness of the color, or we can say it represents luminance or saturation of the color. So this is how the chromaticity diagram looks. Now this figure is related to the two-dimensional representation of the chromaticity diagram, on which x and y axis are used, and they are represent the hue and saturation. So now here from the diagram we come to know, along with the three primary color, that is RGB, there is a mixture of the other colors which are obtained either by using a additive mixing or subtractive mixing. Along with that, we can see the various coordinate, and the central part consists of white area or coordinate C. So at the center of the chromaticity diagram, we get a white color. Now if we look at the shape of the diagram, is nothing but the horseshoe triangular shape. So chromaticity diagram consists of center as a white color along with a mixture of other colors, and it is in the horseshoe shape triangular format color. So now here we can see the various coordinates along with the wavelength of the various color, and the RGB color having a wavelength of 700, 646.1 and 438.8 nanometer respectively. And x and y coordinate denotes the color coordinates, and for example, if we consider x is equals to 0.31 and y is equals to 0.32, then that represents a white color. So let's move back to the diagram. So here the C is nothing but white color, and so if we look at the coordinate, then they belongs to something near about 3. So these coordinates provides the value of C, that is nothing but the white color. Now this is representation of the luminance. That means it is a three-dimensional representation of the chromaticity diagram, in which we require to consider the z-axis, which represents the luminance of the color. So now here also we can see RGB along with the central dot that represents white, and it is denoted by W, and the z-axis is present, which is represents luminance, or we can say brightness of the color. Now here the colored representation of two-dimensional figure of chromaticity diagram. So as discussed, the central part consists of the white color, and the remaining part consists of three primary color along with their mixtures, which are obtained by using additive mixing, in which the colors are get added with each other in certain percentage to obtain the various color, and the subtractive mixing, in which the primary colors get subtracted from each other in a particular amount so that we can get a different values of color. So the chromaticity diagram is basically formed by all the rainbow colors arranged along with the horseshoe shaped triangular curve. So if you look at the diagram again, so the colors belongs to the rainbow color, which is nothing but the primary color and the other colors, and if we consider the center, then it consists of the white color. So this is the representation that is specifically a two-dimensional representation of the chromaticity diagram. The various saturated pure spectral color are represented along with their perimeter of the curve. The corners represent the three primary colors R, G and B. So again, let's move back to the diagram. So here we can see at the corners we have three primary colors, that is R, G and B, and the coordinates of the color represented by using a various values. As the central area of the triangular curve is approached, the color becomes desaturated, representing mixture of the color or a white color. So from the diagram itself, we come to know that when we move to the center, the color is get desaturated. That means more and more white color is get added into the mixture of color, and that forms a center part that is nothing but the white color. The white color lies at the central point C, which is having a coordinate x is equals to 0.31 and x y is equals to 0.32. Just we have saw the diagram which represents the coordinate along with the various wavelength values of RGB color and their mixture. This shade of white, which has been chosen to represent white in the TV transmission and reception, also corresponds to the subjective impression formed in the human eye by seeing the picture for 30% of the red color, 59% of the green color and 11% of the blue color at the wavelength which are specified. So when the human eye receives the mixture of color in this amount, that means when we receive 30% of red color, 59% of green color and 11% of blue color, then that color combination represents as a white color to the human eye. And the same color combination is used in the form of TV white color. A practical advantage of the chromaticity diagram is that it is possible to determine the result of additive mixing of any two color or more color lights by simply geometric construction. So rather than performing the actual mixing of the color by using the additive mixing procedure, with the help of chromaticity diagram, we can get a direct idea about the result of adding two or more than two colors. The color diagram contains all the color of equal brightness, since the brightness is represented by z-axis. As the brightness increases, the color diagram becomes more and more larger. So let's go back to the second figure that also represents the three-dimensional structure of the chromaticity diagram. So now in this diagram, as we consider the z-axis, which represents luminance, and as the brightness is get increases, the diagram is get more and more longer. So the dimension of the chromaticity diagram is depend upon the brightness of the color. So this is what about the chromaticity diagram, which is used for obtaining the value of additive mixing without actual performing mixing of the color. So with the help of these diagram, it is possible to obtain the result without performing the additive mixing of the color. So I hope you understand this diagram of chromaticity, which is used in the color television for producing a light as well as the various colors or mixture of the colors. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.